Okay, so for today's video, we're going to be taking a look at some short division, otherwise known as the bus stop method. For these examples though, we're looking specifically for questions where we're giving our answer as a decimal. For any other videos relevant to this topic, I've put some links in the description and also a card in the top corner, so feel free to check them out. So for this first question, we've got 246 divided by 5. So I'm going to set this up in the usual way. We've got 246, which then we're dividing by 5. So to begin with, I want to see how many times does 5 fit into 2? Well, it doesn't. It fits in 0 times, so I could write that up at the top. But because this is my first digit, I'm just going to leave it. So I'm then going to carry this 2 over to the next digit. I then want to see how many times does 5 fit into 24? Well, this will go 4 times. So I'm going to write that 4 at the top, because 5 multiplied by 4 gives me 20. So we've got 20, we needed 24, that leaves us with a remainder of 4. So we bring that over to the next digit. We then want to see how many times does 5 fit into 46? Well, that'll fit in 9 times, because 5 times 9 is 45, but now we've got a remainder of 1. So because we've got a remainder, what we're going to do now is extend our line. We're going to put a decimal in our answer, a decimal after our 246, and we're just going to write some zeros. I'm going to use 3 just for now. So now I've got something to carry that 1 over to. So because we had a remainder of 1, I'm now going to carry it over to this next digit, which is a 0, so now I've got 10. We now want to see how many times does 5 fit into 10? Well, that'll go 2 times exactly, leaving us with no remainder, so now we can stop. So we have a final answer of 49.2. Okay, for this next question, we're going to do exactly the same thing. This time, though, we've got 315 divided by 6. So to begin with, I want to see how many times does 6 fit into 3? Well, it won't, so again, we could put a 0 here, but as it's our first digit, we don't need to put a 0 right at the front, so I'm just going to carry this 3 over. We now want to see how many times does 6 fit into 31? Well, that'll go 5 times, because 6 multiplied by 5 gives us 30, leaving us with a remainder of 1. So I carry that over to the next digit. We now want to see how many times does 6 fit into 15? Well, that'll fit in twice, because 6 times 2 is 12, and that's going to leave us a remainder of 3. So because we've still got a remainder and we've reached our last digit, we're going to extend our line, put a decimal in the answer, a decimal after our 315, and we're just going to put some zeros. Again, I'm just going to use 3. So going back to what we did, we had 6 times 2, which was 12. We needed 15. That leaves us with a remainder of 3. So that's what we carry over to this 0. We now want to see how many times does 6 fit into 30? Well, that'll go 5 times exactly, leaving us with no remainder. So our answer to 315 divided by 6 would be 52.5. Okay, we've got some more questions to have a go at now. Feel free to pause the video here and have a go at these, and we'll go through the solutions in just a few moments. Okay, for this first question, we've got 33 divided by 4. So to begin with, we want to see how many times does 4 fit into 3? Well, it doesn't, so I'm just going to carry that 3 over to the next digit. We now want to see how many times will 4 fit into 33? Well, that'll go 8 times, because 8 times 4 is 32, that's going to leave us a remainder of 1. So because we've reached our last digit, we're going to extend our line, put a decimal in the answer, a decimal after our 33, and again, we're just going to write some zeros here. So going back to what we did last, we had 8 times 4, which is 32. That left us with a remainder of 1, so that's what I'm going to carry over. So now I've got 10. So how many times does 4 fit into 10? Well, that'll go twice, because 4 times 2 is 8, leaving us with a remainder of 2. So I carry that over to the next digit. We now want to see how many times does 4 fit into 20? Well, that'll go 5 times exactly, leaving us with no remainder. So our answer to this first question would be 8.25. Okay, moving on, we've now got 345 divided by 6. So we want to see how many times does 6 fit into 3? Well, it doesn't, so we're going to carry that 3 over to the next digit. We now want to see how many times does 6 fit into 34? Well, that'll go 5 times, because 6 times 5 is 30, leaving us with a remainder of 4. So I carry that 4 over. We now want to see how many times does 6 fit into 45? Well, that'll go 7 times, because 7 times 6 is 42, leaving us with a remainder of 3. So because we've still got a remainder, we're going to extend our line, put a decimal in the answer, a decimal down here in our 345, and we're going to put some zeros. So going back to what we did last, 7 times 6 was 42. We needed 45, so there was a remainder of 3. So that's what we carry over. We now want to see how many times does 6 fit into 30? Well, that fits 5 times exactly. So because we've got no remainder, we've reached our final answer. So the answer to this one would be 57.5. And for this last question here, we've got 702 divided by 8. So again, we want to see how many times does 8 fit into 7? Well, it doesn't, so we're going to carry that 7 over to the next digit. So we want to see how many times does 8 fit into 70? Well, that'll fit 8 times, because 8 times 8 is 64. That leaves us with a remainder of 6. So I carry that 6 over to my next digit. We now want to see how many times does 8 fit into 62? Well, that'll go 7 times, because 7 times 8 is 56. Which leaves us with a remainder of 6. But because I've got a remainder still, I'm going to extend my line, put a decimal in the answer, a decimal down here, and then I'm going to put some zeros down. So going back, the last thing we did was 7 times 8, which was 56. We needed 62, so there was a remainder of 6, so that's what we carry over. So we've now got 60. So we want to see how many times does 8 fit into 60? Well, that'll be 7 again, because we know 8 times 7 is 56. This time leaving us with a remainder of 4, so I carry over a 4 to my next digit. We now want to see how many times does 8 fit into 40? Well, that'll go 5 times exactly, leaving us with no remainder, so we've reached our final answer. So 702 divided by 8 is 87.75. So well done if you followed along with those. We've got just a couple more questions to finish off with. Again, feel free to have a go at these first, and we'll go through the solutions in just a few moments. Okay, for this first question, we've got 3,258 divided by 12. So let's begin with, we want to see how many times does 12 fit into 3? Well, it doesn't, so we're going to carry that 3 over to the next digit. We then want to see how many times does 12 fit into 32? Well, that'll go twice, because 12 times 2 is 24, which leaves us with a remainder of 8. So I'm going to carry that 8 over to my next digit. We now want to see how many times does 12 fit into 85? Well, that'll go 7 times, because 7 times 12 is 84, which leaves us with a remainder of 1. So I carry that over. We then want to see how many times does 12 fit into 18? Well, that'll go once, because 12 times 1 is 12. That's going to leave us with a remainder of 6. Because I've reached my last digit, I'm going to extend my line, put a decimal in the answer, a decimal down here, and then I'm just going to put some zeros. So going back to the last thing we did, 12 multiplied by 1 was 12. We needed 18. That left us with a remainder of 6. So we've now got 60. So now 12 into 60 will go 5 times exactly, leaving us with no remainder, meaning we found our final answer. So our answer to this one would be 271.5. And for our final question, we've got 7,007 divided by 14. So to begin with, we want to see how many times does 14 fit into 7? Well, it doesn't, that'll be 0. So I could write a 0 at the beginning, but because that's my first digit, I don't need to. So all I'm going to do is carry over my 7 to the next digit. I now want to see how many times does 14 fit into 70? Well, that'll fit in 5 times exactly, because 14 times 5 is 70. So now I move along to my next digit, which is 0. I want to see how many times does 14 fit into 0? Well, it doesn't, and that'll be 0. So now I need to write a 0 in my answer. As I said earlier, the only time we don't need to do this is if we have a 0 here, right at the beginning. So it fits in 0 times, so I then have to carry that 0 over to the next digit. So now I've got 07, which is just 7. So I want to see how many times does 14 fit into 7? Well, again, that's 0, so I need to put another 0 in my answer here. Because 14 times 0 is 0, so we've still got a remainder of 7. So because we've reached our last digit and we still have a remainder, we need to extend our line, put a decimal in the answer, a decimal down here, and you're going to put some zeros down. So going back to what we had last, we had 14 times 0 is 0. We needed 7, so we've still got a remainder of 7. So that's what I'm going to carry over to my next digit. So now I want to see how many times does 14 fit into 70? Well, we know from earlier that 14 times 5 is 70 exactly. So now we have no remainders left, so we've come to our final answer. So 7,007 divided by 14 is 500.5. And that's it for today's video. Well done if you followed along with those questions. I hope you found this video useful. If you did, please feel free to leave a like and consider subscribing. If there are at all any topics that you'd like me to go through next, then please just let me know down in the comments, and I'll try to make some videos on those topics as soon as possible. So thank you very much for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.